growing backlash over controversial new laws in Mississippi and North Carolina. Mississippi's governor signing a sweeping religious freedom bill into law that businesses to refuse service to LGBT people. In North Carolina, PayPal pulling out of a planned global hub in Charlotte over a similar law. More than 100 CEOs now calling on that state's governor to repeal that law. Joining us now, Sarah Warbelow. She is legal director for Human Rights Campaign, and North Carolina State Representative Paul Stam is co-sponsor of House Bill 2. Have a thought-provoking conversation with the two of you. Thank you so much for joining us and bringing both of your voices to this. Paul, I want to start with you. Some are wondering if this is a move by the conservatives as a new strategy in response to SCOTUS's ruling on gay marriage. We've seen North Carolina, Mississippi now passing these laws. What's your reaction to that?
I read the Mississippi law last night. There's not a lot of overlap between it and North Carolina's law. North Carolina's law is more of a reaction to a really extreme, weird ordinance passed by the city of Charlotte a couple of weeks ago.
Sarah, extreme, weird ordinance? What do you think? How do you respond to that?
Nonsense. This is perfectly standard. The city of Charlotte passed an ordinance similar to one passed in Minneapolis in 1975. We have over 40 years of experience with core non-discrimination ordinances at the city and state level that provide basic protections to LGBT people in every area of their lives.
So what we've seen in North Carolina specifically is that there are big corporations that are saying, hey, we're going to pump the brakes on doing business with you. We've seen PayPal canceling a new operation center in Charlotte. It was going to have employed 400 people. We see Lionsgate was planning to shoot a pilot for Hulu. They've now moved that to Vancouver. The NBA is reconsidering having its 2017 All-Star Game inside in North Carolina. 120 voices of businesses, Paul, have responded and say, we're not okay with this. How do you respond to that?
Let me talk about PayPal and NBA. A couple things I don't understand. When PayPal made its announcement that it was coming 3 weeks ago, North Carolina had the same law on discrimination that it has today. I don't know if they were unaware of that. Secondly, North Carolina today has the same law statewide as 32 other states. And the third thing, and this is the same with the NBA, talking about not bringing a All-Star game to Charlotte. The Charlotte action is what PayPal and NBA said they wanted to see, so they're punishing Charlotte. I mean, only Charlotte will suffer from that, not the rest of the state of North Carolina. It's like calling in airstrikes on your own position.
Sarah, what's your response to that?
Weird.
The North Carolina law is uniquely terrible. I think maybe some of the legislators would understand it better if they'd spent more than 12 hours shoving it through from both houses and signed into law. It strips away protections for people of all characteristics, race, sex, disability. It forces people to file lawsuits at the federal level instead of the state level like they used to be able to do so. It stops cities from protecting their residents and visitors, including LGBT people, and then has outrageous provisions making a subset of women, transgender women and girls, enter into men's restrooms in public buildings from libraries to some of the major airports in the city. It's truly outrageous, and that's why we've seen almost overwhelmingly businesses opposed.
Go ahead, Paul.
Almost none of that's accurate. I'll take a few of the points. They claim we took away rights for the handicapped or disabled. No, we have an entire other statute with full remedies and comprehensive coverage for those with disabilities. We took away no rights for those based on race, color, national origin. We did not force people into the wrong restroom. Quite to the contrary, the Charlotte ordinance applied to 20,000 businesses within the city of Charlotte that would then have to change all of their company policies. Our bill only applies to government buildings and school and public schools.
We know there is a we know there's a new law as well in Mississippi, and we can pull that up really quickly. Some of the things that denial of services based on belief, marriage between a man and woman, sexual relations are reserved to marriage. Gender is determined at birth. Sarah, we know that these kind of laws can affect the bottom line of a state. Can Mississippi, the poorest state in the nation, can they afford that? We need a quick response from you.
I think not. Already businesses have spoken out, including major employers like Toyota and Nissan. This is bad for business. It's bad for the reputation of Mississippi, and the state really can't afford it.
We likely will be talking about this for some time. We want to thank you both, Paul Stam and Sarah Warbelow. Thank you so much for joining us on New Day.